Yo, monkeys, it's time for DDP TV.
Self high five.
Hey guys, and welcome to the new DDP TV. Today I'm going to be showing you episode number 2 of the interview slash story time. I guess it really wasn't an interview. It's more like story time with me and Rob Van Dam. I'm going to show you part 2 of that footage. Then I'm going to take RVD and Justin McCulley into the war room, and we're going to get it on with some YRG. And we'll see if Justin's B-minus game that he said he was going to bring was enough. At the end of this episode, I will also be announcing who got this super cool DDP Classic Superstars figure that is signed three-time world champion, bang! Diamond Dallas Page. Someone's going to win that at the end of the show, so stay tuned. And I'll also be showing you what I'm going to be giving you next week.
And then when I started kickboxing, because I wanted to be in the ring.
Now, how old were you then?
We were driving, so I'm going to say 16-ish, maybe 17.
Right.
So, and the thing was, there was a guy in town that had a ring, you know, like this.
Right.
And it was the only chance ever where we could actually get a real ring, you know, until we're older. And so we knocked on the guy's door. He's a kickboxing promoter. And he says, you guys do what? You know, yeah, in the living room on Monday nights, we get the living room cushions and put them on the floor. And we're awesome. We have all these matches. And he said, could you do that in front of people? We were like, that's what we want to do.
And you have that dream.
American dream.
So he said he does kickboxing shows. And then he said he could like put us wrestling on to open the show or something. And we were just like,
so you're for no training. This is just for watching and not having anyone even grab you and lock up or anything because you were.
We really didn't know what we thought we did, but we could work together. We choreographed everything.
Right, right.
But we were acrobatic, you know, and then through this guy, we learned how to add martial arts to it because he said, show up Wednesday, we're going to be working out. And what happened was we'd show up, we'd have to go through all of his stretches, all of his drills.
Oh,
his
wow. Kicks.
We'd even have to spar with his kickboxers, and after everyone was tired and the kickboxers went home, then the wrestlers could have the ring, you know? So that's how I got into doing both of them, and I found out I was really good with kickboxing.
Wow.
And now we're kids challenging each other, and I'm knocking everybody out. And I was thinking, like, really pursuing that, you know, but obviously I added some of what I was learning there to wrestling, and then to supplement what I was learning there, I took whatever martial arts were available around town. You know, there was, like, Todd Tatumi's Taekwondo, and then at the Kellogg Community College, we taught some Tung Sudo, and then there was Aikido, Karate, and Kendo
so
with the Bad
Boy. So all that.
Well, I was taking coupons from the coupon books, two free weeks here and there,
right,
whatever
right.
I could do, but through all that, I learned the importance of stretching, and I really...
Because they all do that.
They all do that. I would have to do it in a class-like format with everyone else, and I just kept it up.
Wow.
Over the years, I add a few new stretches every year, you know, to my hour-like routine that I use, and it, just like stuff that I find useful, like sometimes it's a variation, you know, of a body position or something. Just like I have no doubt after experiencing YRG, there's going to be some things that I'm going to keep.
Absolutely.
As well.
Okay, guys, now we're going to take you onto the mat, into the workout, the YRG workout. By the way, YRG, you're ready, go. It's not yoga. And that's why I had fun with it throughout these interviews, saying it's not yoga. It's YRG, Daddy. DDP, Zero Impact Fitness. Now, we're not just going to show you the whole workout. We're going to show you little clips. We're going to speed it up. We're going to have fun with it. But you're going to see the results, which will be how sweaty the mat gets. Okay. The gimmick here is dynamic resistance. Now I want you to reach out and grab the goal. And I want you to imagine your body's a fire hydrant. The fire hydrant comes on, bang! Hands bang. Up water. Forearms, bicycle, loose fingers, walk along. Tight like that. That's it. Like steel. Perfect. Breathe. Focus on your breath. Excellent. Everything's loose but this right here. And then reach for the sky. Call this touchdown. Exhale, lower. Just turn the palms down right here. Close it out. Try to get that stretch. Take it back. Arms out for the team. Get strong. And jump. And each shake it out. Great job. Zero Impact Fitness. YRG. Alright, now we're done with the workout, and I wanted to get what Justin McCulley and RVD thought right after the workout, because nothing is fresher in their mind than what they just went through. So, what I love about these two guys are, they're not going to tell me what I want to hear. They're going to tell me what they really feel. And if you know RVD or Justin McCulley, you know that's the straight shit.
You're sustaining position and you're trying to hold a position. So like it goes hand in hand with posing, holding the position, trying to secure what you're doing.
So it's really great for grappling?
Excellent for grappling. When you're engaging in grappling and trying to sustain a position in a match, you have that static resistance of you using all your energy, but trying to stay calm, collected, keep a poker face, keep your breath about you, keep your composure, but all the while you're working and really holding a position as hard as you can. So it goes hand in hand with YRG and what we were just doing. And all the breathing and the movements that you do to keep yourself composed and keep your muscles energized with the proper oxygen and blood flow while you're doing it. This is definitely will build your endurance for grappling. I'll give you a prime example right now here. Officer X, let me bar you. Come here, lay down right here. I'm gonna hit the side on Officer X, right? And Officer X is gonna do that, go down on your back. Like even an easy position like this, boom. I'm gonna be kicking it and I'm gonna be relaxed, right? It looks like I'm relaxed, but really I'm engaged. Everything's engaged. My muscles engaged here, my chest is engaged here, my toes are engaged, my thighs are engaged. Just like when we're doing this and bringing our thighs up here inside ourselves and tucking our tailbone in. That's exactly what we're doing right here to gain all this pressure and all this position over on top of them. So everything that we're doing right now works hand in hand with YRG and jiu-jitsu or grappling. He can't just squirm and get away. That tension, that frozen muscle, or the isolation of the muscle and the strength and being able to endure the ride and hold him here in this firm position without getting gassed or losing your composure is imperative to victories in MMA. So, right again, our YRG is exactly what we're just working
on. Hey, let's show us some diaphragm tucks.
Some diaphragm tucks?
That was impossible, okay.
Can you push it out, pull it back out? Back out,
Alright, so this is Rob Van Dam here to tell you firsthand, YRG's no joke. Diamond Dallas Page put myself and Justin McCulley, good friend, UFC MMA fighter Justin McCulley, through this workout, man, and it's not something you can sleep through. I poured so much sweat, I had to keep moving around on the floor to try to find a dry spot, completely soaked my shirt, and found it, you know, to be very challenging. So in fact that you can kind of put more into it if you want to, and the more comfortable you get with holding your foundation and possibly like knowing the movements, then you can put more into it, because a lot of it has to do with holding positions that at first seem awkward until you find your center of balance, and also holding body movements that seem unnatural to get into these poses, but it's all something that the more you get into and the more that you can see where your targeted body parts are really benefiting from this, then you can invest more into it and say, oh yeah, I feel it right there, that's really good, yeah, and open up even more. So a lot of stretching to open you up, a lot of movement to keep your heart rate up, a lot of balance, and it was a good workout, you know. So thanks DDP.
Well, as you can see, DDP, YRG, all right, you got me. It was good stuff. Tough workout. Definitely goes hand in hand with MMA or any sport you're gonna do. In one swoop, you know, stretching session.
Stretching session.
It's my zero impact fitness, YRG.
It was incredible. My heart rate spiked up to 160, 165, and came back down and back up and back down. It was an incredible interval training of stretches and poses and counting down different positions into an insane workout. Literally, I'm giving it the insane workout level. It's not for anybody. I mean, it is for everyone, but at the same time, you gotta bring your A game. He wasn't lying. I might have brought a B minus game today, but next time it's gonna be A plus, because I know what to expect. That was sick. Thanks, DDP. You the man.
Okay, guys, so that's the show. So, who won the classic Superstars action figure? I'll tell you. First, I have to look at his name. Okay, it was New Wave Fan 1. That's right, brother. You won the three-time world champion, bang! Autographed Diamond Dallas Page action figure. That was this week. We'll be putting a picture up of him holding the action figure so you can see this is legit. Now, next week, what can you win? How about this right here? You can win the DDP YRG Fitness System t-shirt with the bang hands on them. How do you win it? Well, simple. You got to subscribe to the blog. One. Number two, you got to hit the like button. Number three, you got to put a comment. I don't care what word you use this week. Matter of fact, I do. Start off with the word yo.
Hey, yo.
From there. So that's it for today. That's the end of our episode. Now we're going to be starting a whole new DDP TV. Next week, I'm going to be featuring right here on DDP TV.
DDP Changing Lives.
Now, eventually, I'm going to bring in some of the people I'm working with, just like you see on Biggest Loser. And you can see these people as they go through their transformations. But initially, I'm going to start out showing you people who have made amazing transformations. Like this guy right here. His name is Arthur Borman. He was walking on those canes for 15 years. He went from this guy to this guy. Boom. You want to see that transformation? Check in next week. You'll be able to get a chance to win a t-shirt. That's all I got to say for today. It's been your pleasure. Wait a minute. You know what I forgot? Wah, wah, wah. My picky eaters. That's right. The greatest chocolate chip cookie you've ever eaten. It's gluten-free, it's dairy-free, it's one of the best chocolate chips ever. But we got brownies, chocolate moon pies, all sorts of great things going to be on that site. Go to My Picky Eaters, wah, 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 if you want to have some kick-ass, unbelievably healthy treats. That's all I got. It's been your pleasure, monkeys. See ya. Bye!
Self high five.